if you're looking to make new friends, find a significant other, or simply expand your social circle, you'll have a crystal clear idea on how to meet new people by the end of this video through my experience that I'll be sharing. And if you stick until the end of the video, I'll have 3 bonus tips on how to start conversations with strangers and build deep, meaningful connections from the start. Are you ready? Cue the intro. So, a few months ago, I finished my master's degree, and I made a conscious decision to move away from campus closer to the location of my new job. The biggest downside of this decision was that I had to forsake my solid social circle. Close friends, previous classmates, previous coworkers, gym buddies, virtually everyone. But it wasn't something I hadn't done before in the past. In fact, ever since I was 16, I've been moving from state to state, from country to country. This time, it was a little different. Since I wasn't in college anymore, I had to go out of my way to meet new people and form new relationships. For a while though, I kind of dwelled in complacency. I'd wake up early in the morning, get to work, get off work around late afternoon, go straight to the gym and exercise, come back home, cook, work on my projects, sleep, rinse, and repeat. And it started to get too comfortable. And there's one thing that I personally despise is getting too comfortable to the point of complacency. So I decided it was time to take action. In less than 2 weeks, I had met over 50 people and built some sort of connection with about half of them. How did I do that? Well, it was the combination of modern means and old school ways. First, the modern way, aka apps. While we live in a digital world that seems to disconnect us from real human interactions, there exist other avenues within that same digital world seeking to actively reconnect us. And it would be insane not to take advantage of such tremendous opportunity to build new connections. I personally use 2 main apps to meet new faces on a weekly basis, Meetup and Hinge. Let's first start with Meetup. By the way, this is not a sponsored video for either of these apps. So Meetup is an incredible app that allows you to connect with people that have the same interests as you do, or to try out new activities with complete strangers. So far, I've used the Meetup app for volleyball and soccer games over the weekend, as well as to find open mic nights to play my guitar within my neighborhood. I intend to use it next for business purposes. So, the process was extremely simple. I downloaded the app for free, expressed my interest, sports, music, and business, and then joined the groups with similar interest. The ideal case is to join a group with thousands of members so that there are multiple events going on within the same group, and that way we'll have your pick of activities to participate in virtually every day if you so desire. The other app that I've also been using actively is Hinge. Hinge is a dating app to meet high quality members of the opposite sex. I find Hinge to be very convenient because I get to chat with highly educated people, and when there's mutual interest, we schedule dates at our own convenience. I've tried a few dating apps, and trust me, Hinge is by far the best dating app as of 2019. Give it a shot, unless you're interested in casual relationships with usually lower quality women, in which case you should definitely give Tinder a shot. Your life, your choices. Hinge and Meetup are really effective if you live near huge metropolitan cities such as Denver, where I live, Houston, New York City, LA, and the like. But if you live in a relatively small town, you're much better off meeting new people using the traditional ways. By traditional ways, I mean meeting people through your existing connections or through activities you already participate in. For instance, I love making new friends in the gym. And here's the first bonus tip I promise you guys, how to make new friends in the gym. When I get to the gym and it's very packed, I walk up to any random guy or gal and ask him, how many more sets do you have left? They usually respond with, I have X more sets left. To which I reply, well, I'll be standing nearby, just let me know when you're done. And I follow with, my name is Guess, by the way, what's your name? And where are you from? What do you do? And boom, conversation started. And just like that, next time I come to the gym, I have a new acquaintance with who I can discuss the weather, the week, or even plans to hang out in the future. Last and most powerful bonus tip for those of you who've made it this far, thank you, by the way. So, if you want to build a very deep, meaningful connection with a stranger you've just met, ask them this one question in the middle of the conversation. So, what's your story? Then shut up and watch them unveil their life story, from which you can learn things you have in common and decide whether or not it's someone you want to include in your social circle. Another traditional way of meeting new people and discovering events you'd be interested in attending is by tapping directly into your existing connections. Guess how I heard about the Meetup app? A colleague at work. You'd be surprised how much you can learn about what's happening in town through mundane conversations with your colleagues and classmates and gym buddies. Speaking of, I had one of the best nights of my life with one of my gym buddies and a yoga partner that I connected with by just initiating a conversation. But that's probably a story for another video. In summary, here is how I expanded my social circle and continue to do so. I use digital means such as the Meetup and Hinge apps, as well as old school means such as traditional word of mouth from my existing social circle. I would like to wrap this video up right here, but before I do so, here's my final word of wisdom. I personally believe that it is highly counterproductive to try to fill a void within myself with just meeting people. That's why I put a huge emphasis and huge value on spending time alone through meditation, yoga, and journaling. And those, my friends, will be the subject matters of the next video. But for now, I challenge you to use one of the three ways I've shared in this video to make 5 new friends, or at least get 5 new names and phone numbers. As usual, if you learned anything new at all, smash that like button and let me know in the comments below what are your favorite ways to make new friends and meet new people. This was Guest for your weekly dose of inspiration and motivation on Guestivation. Peace.